Stargazer Shootout.
Hey there, Stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. We're here to help you find your way around the sky. You may not know this, but astronomers can be kind of competitive.
A friendly, nerdy kind of competitive. Often when they get together at conferences, they compete in a star and constellation shootout. Basically, the astronomers sit in a planetarium, turn off the lights, put the stars on the ceiling, and start naming stars and constellations.
They point at each object with a red laser, give the name, and if correct, move on to the next round. If they're wrong or can't find a star or constellation they know, they're out.
The last astronomer standing, or sitting, wins. So James and I are going to go head-to-head for your entertainment this week.
That's right. Two titans at the peak of their stargazing abilities. Dean, with his knowledge of obscure star names.
And James, with his constellation connoisseurship.
Connoisseurship?
That's not a word, is it?
Nope.
Anyway, let the great star and constellation shootout begin.
Okay, are you ready, Four Eyes?
Bring it on, Stargeezer. We've got our skies set for 10:30 p.m. looking east. Here you can find Leo the Lion, recognizable by the backward question mark of stars for his head and a triangle of stars for his rear end.
Correct. And Leo's brightest star is called Regulus, meaning little king.
Correct, for the king of the beasts. And there is Algeba, a nice double star.
Above Algeba is Aldifera.
And toward the lion's rear is the star Zosma.
And just rising in the east is Denebla, the tail of Leo the Lion.
So far, so good, Albury.
Now we're facing south at 10:30 p.m. and we can see Orion high in the sky.
Below him is the rabbit constellation called Lepus.
Above Orion's right shoulder is Taurus the Bull.
And to the right of Lepus is the constellation Eridanus. Okay, James, since you picked Orion, I challenge you to a star lightning round.
Oh, goody.
Okay, we're zoomed in on Orion and we're going to name stars. Go.
Rigel.
Bellatrix.
Misa.
Alnitak.
Alnilam.
Mintaka.
Safe.
Beetlejuice.
Ah, good play, Mr. Regas.
We could be here all night. Okay, now we're facing southeast at 9 p.m. There's Sirius, the brightest star in the sky.
Who's part of the constellation Canis Major.
There's the bright yellow star Procyon.
Also known as the little dog star in the constellation Canis Minor.
There's the yellow-orange star Pollux.
And blue-white Castor above it.
Who are the heads of the constellation Gemini the Twins.
Okay, what's that star above Procyon?
Gomesa, the other star in Canis Minor. I know, that constellation is a real hot dog, but what's the star between the Gemini twins and Orion's Betelgeuse?
Alhina, the heel of Pollux. What's Canis Major's paw star called?
Oh, that's Merzom. Ooh, here's a toughie. What's the faint constellation between Canis Major and Canis Minor?
That's Monoceros, the unicorn, a constellation invented by the Dutch cartographer Petrus Plancius in the 17th century to fill in the empty space.
You're good, Albury. Very good.
You've also proven to be a worthy opponent.
Finally, we're facing north at 10 p.m., and we see Polaris, a.k.a. the North Star, about halfway up in the sky.
Polaris marks the tail of the Little Bear, the constellation Ursa Minor.
It's also part of the asterism called the Little Dipper. The stars marking the end of the Little Dipper's spoon are called Kochab.
And Firkhead.
To the right is Ursa Major, a huge constellation that contains the stars in the Big Dipper.
Which includes the stars Alcade,
Mizar,
with a tiny little star above it called Alcor, barely visible to the naked eye.
Then there's Alioth,
faint little Megrez,
Vecta,
Merak,
and Dubi. Well, we just correctly identified a heck of a lot of stars and constellations.
Yep, and I bet we have a lot more we could name if we only had more time.
Well, what do you say we call it a tie?
Sounds good.
Now, if we can learn all these stars and constellations in the sky, you can too. Just follow our simple advice and
keep looking up.